The few minutes at Damodar Kund. The Mylapore lady had painted a rosy picture of Damodar Kund when booking our tickets for the trip. The helicopter will halt there for half an hour. You can have your holy bath in the Kundam. Plenty of shalagramams will be found and Abhisheka can be performed to those with the sacred water of that tank. If milk is used for Abhisheka, it's even more conducive to holiness. Diamond and precious stones may be found there. But by appearance, they will all look like ordinary stones only. They cannot, however, be brought from there. I have gone there myself, but could fetch only a few shalagramams, she had said, which I could recollect at Damodar Kund. I could also run through my mind the lamentation of a lady in the helicopter for not having brought milk for Abhisheka, saying that it was unfortunately not available in Pokhara, and that Damodar Kund was the only place where women could perform the Abhisheka, as learnt by her. But what follows from now onwards is the real state of affairs, as experienced by me in those high altitudes. Since Damodar Kund is at a height of several thousands of feet above the sea level, oxygen was less in that ambience, and the wind force beyond tolerance. It was hard to stand there steadily, and even talking to another person with clarity was found difficult. It appeared that the mind was not fully conscious and the brain functions were not at their optimum. There was a bank skirting the pond, and at a large empty space nearby, our helicopter was parked with its engine kept running. Otherwise, if there should have been trouble in restarting it, we all could have been stranded there. There were three tanks, ponds, proximate to the place, described in the Puranas as Damodar Kunda, Sweta Kunda and Rakta Kunda. Those who had come with me hastened towards the Damodar Kund. I went hurriedly to the other side of the tank to click my camera, but could not do that due to the icy chillness that had numbed my fingers. Keeping my finger on the click button, I had to use my other hand to press it hard. For taking video also, I faced problems, as even standing there was found to be next to impossible. The helicopter was making awful noise, adding to the inhospitable conditions there. I trembled in fear when I realized that we were alone at a very high altitude, surrounded by only the voidness of vast space, cut off from human habitation. But soon I regained my composure and started taking pictures. The sun was dipping down and it was becoming cloudy. The other members were filling their containers with the holy water, and I could see a person who had slipped in the water being pulled out by the others. A lady who had accompanied us from the group in another bus was seen taking photographs. By then, 5 minutes had passed. At that stage, a crew member came to me and said authoritatively, "Why have you come so far? You should have had a view from there here itself." It was not apparent whether he had heard my response, but he hastened me up, telling, "Please come, the weather condition is worsening." I said, "The tour operator told us we can spend 20 minutes here and still quarter of an hour is left. Fuel is getting exhausted rapidly and we cannot take any risk. In 5 minutes, we should be off from here." He cautioned me and ran towards the others. I went to the second tank and started taking pictures when Balaji Rao came there. At that moment, when I had turned my look towards the edge of the pool, I could see in the shallow water a splendid Sudarshana Shalagrama of large size. "Balaji, see, I'm picking up a Shalagrama," I said, and knelt near the spot of the find. It was a palm-sized Sudarshana Shalagrama with golden stripes, and I became thrilled at having got it as a rare treasure. I felt overjoyed that what I could not get in the Gandaki River in 2004, despite my earnest efforts and devout prayers, was now available at arm's length, and it looked as if the Shalagrama itself was indicating to me, "See, it's for you that I have come to the surface. Pick me up." I visualized Sri Guru Raja telling me, I am aware of the torment you suffered that day, your eyes searching everywhere in the Gandaki. Your failed attempts to visit Damodar Kund are also known to me. But this time I wanted to prevent such agony being experienced by you, and therefore I have shown you the Salagrama with golden markings instantly. Pick it up. I took it at once, as I felt that Sri Guru Raja himself was prompting me to do that. Of course, I did not feel bad that I was hastening to lift it when another person who had sighted it at the same moment was by my side. It was only later that the impropriety occurred in my mind, but I reconciled myself that the impulsiveness I had exhibited was after all because of the joy of seeing there the thing that I had missed in 2004. When I examined what other things could be found there, several black-coloured objects were sighted below the water. I was not sure whether I could place my foot in the tank, as I feared that taking the leg out of the icy chill water could be problematic. And besides, there may even be soft clay in that place, burying the leg deep inside. When I was mulling about these possible hazards, the co-pilot signaled to me to return at once to the helicopter. I did not, however, pay heed to his shouts and placed my foot in the pond, and after picking up two black objects of betel nut size, I tried to lift my leg out of the pond. Alas, I could not do that, and the helicopter crew member, seeing my plight, came there and pulled me out of that quagmire with an admonition. He bawled out, "Why are you delaying like this? The weather is turning bad. It is risky to be here any longer," dragging me to the helicopter. My pleadings that only 10 minutes had passed and the climatic conditions had not deteriorated fell only on deaf ears. A little later, he left his hold on my hand and started running to everyone, directing all passengers to get into the helicopter at once. As my seat was near the door, I got inside the helicopter last, viewing Damodar Kund every second of the available time with a rather heavy heart. I could not, however, help grieving that if Damodar Kund was only this much, I had waited unduly long for this kind of an experience. Soon we were airborne, and before I could have a last look at Damodar Kund from the sky, it had already gone out of my visual range. The aerial view of the golden-hued mountain range, though pleasing to the eye and the mind, there was yet some heaviness in my heart which was conspicuous. Oh, how much I had craved to visit this holy place! How many stories I had heard of it, always entertaining hopes of a darshan to my heart's content. But in just 10 minutes, they have all petered out into oblivion. Though there was a sense of achievement at heart that I had had darshan of a very holy place, one that was not easily accessible, yet many questions and diverse thoughts crowded my mind. Things I had heard about the place being visualized sequentially, like the white Chakranike being available in plenty at the place of mingling of the Gomati River with the sea in Dwarka. I had imagined that the black-coloured Salagrama will be in abundance in Damodar Kund and on its banks, but it was quite a different experience there. The tank, acclaimed as the holy Damodar Kund, was found to be only a sacred pond existing in that high altitude, raising the awe whether that was the fountainhead of thousands of Salagramas. It also left me in wonderment whether that was the source of the Gandaki River. Since none except me had got a Salagrama from there, a co-passenger exclaimed whether we had come to the right place. But there was no doubt about it at all, since I had seen the locale in videos and photographs which had left their impress in my mind. We had gone there in the month of May. Perhaps at other times, Salagramas in large numbers could be emerging in the waters there, and maybe at those times it would not be possible to have access to that place. For the thousands of Salagramas on the Brindavanas all over the country and in the puja of the Pitadhipatis of various matas, besides those at the houses of devotees in large number, are those obtained from this source only. As salagramas cannot be produced artificially, they being self-creations. Sriman Narayana has no birth or end, nor embryonic origin. His avatars and birth are traditional and time-honored. Such Lord takes himself the shape of salagrama, symbolic of Hari. A salagrama cannot be sculpted, fashioned or created, though certain divine images could be carved out on a Hiranyagarbha salagrama or any other such self-creation. Our expectation that Damodar Kund would be brimming with the salagramas and they could be scooped in good number proved utterly off the mark. In Nepal, we had heard in the year 2004 that if a dry stem of the tulsi plant is held near the water, salagramas will come out of their depths in the water for the fragrance of that plant, and that they could be collected in large quantity. But in our brief stay of 10 minutes at the Damodar Kund, such an experiment could not be carried out, and therefore such belief can neither be rejected nor accepted. We were at a loss to know how we had spent those 10 minutes, but in hindsight, I can only recollect that I was not fully cognizant of the happenings then. Whatever little I am penning now are the only thoughts occurring in my mind after intense efforts at recollecting the experiences in those inhospitable conditions. I feel an indescribable kind of joy when I reflect that I could have had darshan of at least the place of advent of the Lord as the symbolic salagrama, Vaikuntha and the milky ocean that are associated with him being beyond our vision and reach. Though Damodar Kund is said to be the source of the Gandaki, we could not see the flow of that holy river from there, at least from the place we were positioned at. Maybe its sources from another end or without flowing outside, it sprouts as a spring from the inner recesses of the earth. To know all these, at least a few hours stay at that spot will be the minimum period one would require for an in-depth study. The helicopter was approaching Muktinath, and what I saw from its height excited me, kindling my hope that there was the possibility of my accomplishing something that was considered otherwise till then. While getting off the helicopter, I thanked the Mailapur lady within my heart, and whatever problems we had all encountered were no longer in my mind. After all, the Damodar Kund darshan was only through her help. It matters little whether it was for 10 or 11 minutes. Money-wise too, whether it was more or less, we could feel satisfied that we had seen the place of advent of the Lord in his symbolic form. With such thoughts in my mind, when I started walking away from the helicopter, I was bubbling with joy at the opportunity presenting itself before me of seeing Muktinarayana again after 5 years. Apart from that, the prospect of my having his darshan in the manner I was earning for it appeared bright, adding to my exuberance.